In the last video, we talked about horizontal asymptotes and what they had to do with limits of a function as x goes to infinity or to minus infinity. In this video, we're going to look at rational functions and see what their limits are as x goes to infinity or minus infinity. Now remember that a rational function is a ratio of two polynomials. So p of x is a polynomial, q of x is a polynomial, and we look at their ratio. So if you have a rational function, what's the limit as x goes to infinity? What's the limit as x goes to minus infinity? We're going to work three examples to give you a sense of what's going on. If you know these three examples, you can handle any rational function. One example has more powers of x upstairs than downstairs. It's got an x squared upstairs, it's only got one power of x downstairs. One example has the same number of powers upstairs and downstairs. And one example has fewer powers of x upstairs than downstairs. So let's tackle them one at a time. So our first example is 3x squared plus 4x minus 1 over 5x plus 7. And our strategy is we're always going to divide by enough powers of x to get rid of the leading power downstairs. So here we have one power of x downstairs. So we're going to divide the top and the bottom by x. And this makes sense because we're not dividing by 0 because we're looking at what happens as x goes to infinity. So it's perfectly okay to divide by x. When we do that, the numerator becomes 3x plus 4 minus 1 over x, and the denominator becomes 5 plus 7 over x. And if you want to know what happens to that as x goes to infinity, well, imagine that you plug in x equals a million. You get 3 million and 4 minus a tiny bit, divided by 5 plus a tiny bit. Well, gigantic number divided by something close to 5 gives you gigantic number. And as x gets bigger and bigger and bigger, the numerator gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and the denominator doesn't. So the limit is infinity. Likewise, if you plug in a gigantic negative number, you get something gigantic. It'll be gigantic and negative in this case. But it's gigantic divided by something close to 5. Well, that gives you gigantic. Negative, but gigantic. Okay. So this is typical of what happens if you have more powers of x upstairs than downstairs. Now let's apply the same trick to an example where you have the same number of powers upstairs and downstairs. So we're going to multiply the top and the bottom by 1 over x squared. Why x squared? Because you have two powers of x downstairs. You always want to multiply by enough things to get rid of all the powers of x downstairs. Okay, 3x squared divided by x squared is 3. 4x divided by x squared is 4 over x. Negative 1 over x squared is minus 1 over x squared. And the denominator becomes 5 plus 7 over x squared. Now, as x goes to infinity, the numerator gets really close to 3. As x goes to infinity, this term gets small, this term gets small, and you're just left with a 3. The denominator gets really close to 5. So the limit of f of x is the limit of the numerator divided by the limit of the denominator, which is 3/5. And likewise, the same thing happens as x goes to minus infinity. Whether you plug in a gigantic positive or negative number, the numerator is close to 3. The denominator is close to 5, the ratio is close to 3/5. And in fact, here's a rough sketch of the graph. It's got an asymptote of 3/5 on the right. It's got the same asymptote of 3/5 on the left. And it happens to take a dip in the middle, where the numerator goes to 0. But you know, all these extra details, those are details that have to do with the fact that you had this 4x and 1 down there. When you're really looking at what happens to infinity, you're essentially looking at what happens to 3x squared over 5x squared. This extra noise doesn't affect the behavior at infinity because after you divide by x squared, it gives you terms that go to 0. Okay. Our last example has more powers downstairs than upstairs. So now we're going to divide by x cubed. and the numerator becomes 3 over x plus 4 over x squared minus 1 over x cubed, divided by 5 plus 7 over x cubed. And that goes to 0 on either end. Whether x goes to infinity or minus infinity, the numerator goes to 0, the denominator goes to 5, 0 divided by 5 is 0. So you have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. So, in summary, whenever you have a ratio of two polynomials, let's suppose you have m powers of x upstairs and n powers of x downstairs, you always take this ratio and you divide by x to the n. Then the numerator will turn into something with fewer powers of x, and the denominator will start with a constant and then get things with negative powers of x. And when you take a limit, all this goes away. And the only question is, what is this term doing? If there are more powers of x upstairs than downstairs, this is blowing up on you. And the limit will either be infinity or minus infinity, depending on whether you're going to plus infinity or minus infinity, and depending on whether am is positive, and bm is positive. There are a bunch of cases, but things will blow up. If they're the same, then this becomes a constant. This goes to am, and you get a ratio of am over bn. And if there are more powers of x downstairs than upstairs, then the numerator goes to 0, and the limit is 0.